Hello, this is the Akanchana Pemikpa University of Skills Training and Entrepreneurial Development, Amsterdam Kumasi. This school was formerly known as the University of Education Unibe Kumasi Campus, but the school are now autonomous with the new name Akanchana Pemikpa University of Skills Training and Entrepreneurial Development, Amsterdam Kumasi. The school is located in Kumasi in the Ashanti region of Ghana. The school is a public or government teacher education university. Let's get into the school and see, as well as to know the programs they offer in this university, as well as the name Akanchana Apiamika. Where is the name coming from? And also the great student. Thank you. Let's go.
Hello, good afternoon. Welcome to the Akanchana Pemikpa University of Skills Training and Entrepreneurial Development, Amsterdam Kumasi, in the Ashanti region of Ghana. And this university was formerly known as the University of Education Unibe Kumasi Campus, but as it stands now, it is no more under the administration of the Unibe Kumasi Campus anymore. Now this university is full, complete, autonomous government university with the new name Akanchana Pemikpa University of Skills Training and Entrepreneurial Development, Amsterdam Kumasi. So that is what you are watching on your screen right now. This is the campus of the Akanchana Pemikpa University of Skills Training and Entrepreneurial Development, Amsterdam Kumasi. This school is a teacher education university. It is a public or government university with the core mandate of providing professional and quality teachers for the nation Ghana. And that is what you are watching on your screen. This is the Akanchana Pemikpa University of Skills Training and Entrepreneurial Development. This university is having two campuses. We have the Asantimapon campus, which was formerly the University of Education campus, and the Kumasi campus, which was formerly University of Education Kumasi campus. These two campuses are now merged together by the government of Ghana and the Parliament House to become one complete, full, autonomous public teacher education university to provide professional and quality teachers for the nation Ghana. And that is what you are watching on your screen. And this is a teacher education university, a public university in the country right now. So we don't have only one teacher education university as we used to have, as a specialized only teacher education university in the country, which was Unibe. Now we have the University of Education Unibe Kumasi campus, we have the University of Education Unibe, and also the Akanchana Pemikpa University of Skills Training and Entrepreneurial Development, Amsterdam Kumasi. So this is the Akanchana Pemikpa University of Skills Training and Entrepreneurial Development, and it is located in Kumasi in the Ashanti region of Ghana. And that is what you are watching on your screen. This is a public teacher education university. So all students that want to enter into the teaching field, now we have another teacher public education university in the campus, in the country, and now you can apply for it and then come here to study any program you want to study in your academic life. So this is the Akanchana Pemikpa University of Skills Training and Entrepreneurial Development. We will also be looking at the name Akanchana Pemikpa. Where is the name coming from? We'll also be looking at that. We'll also look at the programs the university are now offering, since they are now autonomous, because they were offering teacher education programs. Now that they have become autonomous, are they going to deduct some programs, or now we are going to add more programs to the university, to more programs of study in the university? So that is what we want to consider, and that is what we want to take note of it. So this university is not a new university, it is an old university that has been there of old. Just that the name has been changed to Akanchana Pemikpa University of Skills Training and Entrepreneurial Development, Amsterdam Kumasi, because of the school becoming autonomous. So we'll be going for a short break, and then after that we'll bring you all the others that you have to know about the life or the name Akanchana Pemikpa. That is the name Akanchana Pemikpa. That is the new name of the school, where from this name it will bring you all the details in that, where the name is coming from and why this man was this school was being named after this man. We'll bring you all of them after we return from our short break. So stay with us as we go for this short break. We'll bring you the grades students must have in order to get admission into this public wonderful institution. We'll let you know all of them, as well as the programs that the university offers to pay students to study. We'll give you all of that. So stay with us as we go a short commercial break. Hello, the University of Education Mini Kumasi Campus is no more the University of Education Mini Kumasi Campus again. It is the Atingten Akimika University of Skills Training and Entrepreneurial Development, AMSEC Kumasi. This is a public education university in Kumasi in the Ashanti region of Ghana. Therefore, for your public teacher education university, apply at the Atingten Akimika University of Skills Training and Entrepreneurial Development, AMSEC Kumasi. Undergraduate applicant, 200 Ghana cedis, mature applicants, 300 Ghana cedis, international applicants, 100 Ghana cedis, post diploma applicant, 200 Ghana cedis. Apply and then study. Hello, so we welcome you back from the short break, and we are still at the Akenten Akimika University of Skills Training and Entrepreneurial Development, Amstead Kumasi, in the Ashanti region of Ghana. And this is the campus of the Akenten Akimika University of Skills Training and Entrepreneurial Development, Amstead Kumasi, in the Ashanti region of Ghana. And so this particular teacher education public university in the region has now brought the Ashanti region into two public universities in the region. So government granting autonomy to this particular university now brings the Ashanti region into two public universities in the region. At first, we know that it was only Kwame Nkrumah University of Science and Technology was the only university or public university in that region. But now, as we are speaking now, this university being granted autonomy now brings the Ashanti region into two public universities in the region. So when you go to Central Region, we are having University of Education Winneba as one public university in the region, as well as the University of Cape Coast, which is UCC, as also the second or another public university in that region. So that's the Central Region also having two public universities, and this region, Ashanti region, now the inclusion of the Akenten Akimika University of Skills Training and Entrepreneurial Development brings the Ashanti region into two public universities, that the Kwame Nkrumah University of Science and Technology, TECH, as well as the Akenten Akimika University of Skills Training and Entrepreneurial Development, AMSTEC Kumasi. So that is the, so this university particular has, I think, brought some new changes in the nation, as well as the Ashanti region, because now this university becoming autonomous now brings the nation Ghana, or Ghana as a nation, to have two public specialized teacher education universities. That is the University of Education Winneba, and then the Akenten Akimika University of Skills Training and Entrepreneurial Development, Mr. Kumasi, as you are watching on your screen, as well as also the same school bringing the Ashanti region into two public universities, that is the Kwame Nkrumah University, as well as the Akenten Akimika University of Skills Training and Entrepreneurial Development, AMSTED, as you are watching on your screen. So now we come to the most important part of our program. most important part of our program today. Now we come to the most important part of our program today. So we'll be looking at the name Akintena Piaminka, the name Akintena Piaminka of the school. Where from the name? Where is the name coming from? And who is even this Akintena Piaminka? Who is this even Akintena Piaminka? Because when you go to Kwame Nkrumah, say Kwame Nkrumah University of Science and Technology, Kwame Nkrumah, the moment you mention Kwame Nkrumah, you know that you know what Kwame Nkrumah, who he is, you know what he has done for the nation or the country, Ghana, you know, leading the country to independence. You know, we study even about him, even in our schools. Yes, so when you say Kwame Nkrumah, you don't have to ask where who is Kwame Nkrumah, where does he come from, or no. You don't have to ask me because we know the man that he has done a lot for the country and we know him. The same thing applies to the Jerry John Rawlings University Developmental Studies, that is the Tamale campus. You know, now the name is the Jerry John Rawlings University. And now this Jerry John Rawlings, when you mention his name, you know who that man is. You know who he is. You know where he's coming from. You know the name. You know what he has done for the nation. And you don't have to now going to ask who is this man we're talking about, who is Jerry John Rawlings. You don't have to ask because you know him. But if you are saying you can turn up here in country, then who is this Akintena Piaminka? So now we want to know who this man is, Akintena Piaminka. Who is he? Because for the university, we know that the university, we know that this is in Kumasi in the Ashanti region. But the name is Akintena Piaminka University. Then who is this Akintena Piaminka as compared to Kwame Nkrumah University of Science and Technology? We know Kwame Nkrumah, the Jerry John Rawlings University, we know the Jerry John Rawlings. Now it is Akintena Piaminka University. Who is this Akintena Piaminka? And that is what we want to find out. That is what we want to know about Akintena Piaminka. That is why today we are in this particular teacher education university today. This is the Akintena Piaminka University of Skills Training and Entrepreneurial Development, Amstead, Kumasi. So we are going to that, and after that we'll bring you the programs also the school also offers. So now let's quickly enter into Akintena Piaminka University and see the name, or and get to know, I mean, more about the name Akintena Piaminka. So Akintena Piaminka, or Honorable Akintena Piaminka, was born on 3rd July at Abu Abuja, a town in the Kwari district near Kumasi in the Ashanti region of Ghana. And this is the town where Akintena Piaminka was born, Abu Abuja, in the Ashanti region of Ghana. So, Honorable Akintena Piaminka is from Abu Abuja, near the Ashanti region, and he was born year 3rd July 1933. So now we know the year this man was born, 3rd July 1933, and also the town is also what, Abu Abuja, a town in the Kwari district near Kumasi in the Ashanti region. And the mother was Enu Akosua, and the father Openin Amponsa Ediya. But one thing happened, something happened in the life of Akintena Piaminka, and it was because, I mean, it is something very, very sad, because while this man was in the womb of the mother, the father passed away. So when this man, Akintana Pianinka, was in the mother's womb, his father passed away. So this man never got to see the face or the real identity of his father. So this man never saw the face of his father. So that is Akintana Pianinka. Then Akintana Apiaminka, or Honorable Akintana Apiaminka, being born in Abuja in 1933, on 3rd of July, he proceeded to have his middle school education at Abuja Methodist School. So he had his middle school education Abuja Methodist School. He proceeded to Abuja State College, Kibi, for his Cambridge certificate, and Adisade College for his advanced level certificate. He stole away from the Taprade port through a French cargo and landed in Marseille. He was sent to England on train in 1954. There, he enrolled at the Northwestern Polytechnic, London, which is now University of North London, that same year, and obtained his GCE Advanced Level Certificate in 1955. He continued at the University of Manchester in 1956 to study law, and graduated in 1959. So Akintana Pianinka also studied law in the University of Manchester, and he graduated in 1959. So he returned to Ghana in 1960, and entered private legal practice as a barrister and solicitor, working as an associate of the Yanon Chambers, which was then headed by Nicholas Jao Buafo Adadin. So this man, Akintana Pianinka, entered private legal practice as a barrister and a solicitor, working as an associate of the Yanon Chambers, which was then headed by Nicholas Jao Buafo Adadin. Then Akintana Pianinka, or Honorable Akintana Pianinka, worked as a legal practitioner until 1969, when he entered politics. So Akintana Pianinka, or Honorable Akintana Pianinka, actually entered politics in 1969. As a civil servant, he served in the Atamills administration when he was appointed a member of the Constitution Review Commission. So Akintana Pianinka also served during the Atamills, or President Late Atamills administration. Then in 1969, Honorable Akintana Pianinka was elected member of parliament representing the Abuja Kwabre constituency. He contested with Ajiman Alexander Frederick of the National Alliance of Liberals, Balfour Ankoma of the United Nationalist Party, and Otuo Seribu of the People's Action Party. That same year, he was appointed Deputy Minister for Trade. In 1971, after the reshuffle, he was made Deputy Attorney General. So Akintana Pianinka, Honorable Akintana Pianinka, became Deputy Minister for Trade, and also in 1971, also he became also Deputy Attorney General. He served in his position until 1972 when the Busia government was overthrown. He was detained by the Supreme Military Council, which is then the National Redemption Council. After the overthrow, he was released in 1973. He acquired a 600-acre land in Akufum near Obuasi and started a palm oil plantation which became the Ashanti Oil Mills. The company produced edible oil. The business grew to become the Apenten, become the Apia Minka Complex Limited, that manufactured Apino soap. So the Apino soap that were all over in this country, this man Akenten Apia Minka was the one manufacturing all these Apino soap in the country. Well done, Mr. Akenten Apia Minka. A popular detergent soup of the 1980s and crocodile tail. The soup production began in Kumasi through a joint venture with the National Investment Bank. He was managing director and later chairman of the Apia Minka Complex Limited, the Ashanti Oil Mills, and the Apia Minka Plantations. So Akenten Apia Minka became the chairman of the complex, Apia Minka Complex Limited, as well as the Ashanti Oil Mills and the Apia Minka Plantations. Then he was in jail from 1983 to 1984 over a land dispute in the Izma area of the Western region. Due to his industrial exploits, he was once made president of the Association of Ghana Industries. He married Mrs. Rosemond Apia Minka, which is Nijanvi, in 1960. His hobbies include dead golf, football, and cartoon reading. Then, finally, he died on February 13th, 2018. All MPP flags in the various regions and constituencies of the country were flown at him at half mast for 7 days following his death. His burial ceremony was held on 24th May 2018 in Kumasi. He was buried in his hometown, Abu Abuja. So Abu Abuja was where he was finally buried, and that is where he was born to. And he died on 13 February 2018. So Akenten, or Honorable Akenten Apia Minka, after his death, these tributes were paid to him. Nanadu Dankwa Akufo-Addo being the president of Ghana, and the former president, Mr. John Dramani Mahama, paid tribute to Akenten Apia Minka. And these are the tributes that they paid to him. Nanadu Dankwa Akufo-Addo, the president, said, "I have lost a valued senior counselor. He was an invaluable and constant source of advice and prayers for me, and was overjoyed when I won the presidential election in 2016. And also, the former president of Ghana, John Dramani Mahama, also said, "The death of Akenten Apia Minka should charge Ghanaians with the responsibility to continue the pursuit of constitutionalism." So this was also what the president of Ghana, the former president of Ghana, also said, which is John Dramani Mahama, former president of Ghana. So this actually was the life of Akenten Apia Minka, and this is the man Akenten Apia Minka we are talking about. So we have known who this Akenten Apia Minka is, where he is coming from. That is why we named this school after this great honorable man serving as Attorney General, serving as Deputy Minister of Trade, doing this, serving manufacturing of penal soap for the country. You know, this man has served the nation faithfully and honestly. And because of that, it was a great thing to name this particular university after this man, to honor him and also to remember him as a state servant. So that is all about Akinkan Abiam Ika University.